So I'd like to talk with you a little bit now that we've heard a bit about the future and a bit about technology and how that's being used with caregivers to learn more about them. I'd like to talk with you a little bit about how we're using mobile devices to augment dementia care for caregivers, for patients and families, and also for healthcare professionals. This is a disclosure slide to show where my funding comes from and that I don't get paid any extra for any of the things that are related to what I'm going to talk about today. As we all well know, the current state and the future state of Alzheimer's disease and other dementias across the country and across the world is pretty harrowing. We know that as our Earth ages and our population ages, that more and more people are going to develop dementia because we're living longer. We expect that 5 million Americans are living with Alzheimer's disease or some other dementia now, and that by 2050, that number will reach 16 million people. And logistically, the current models of care that we have can't keep up with that. For example, the average visitor that comes to the Stanford VA California Alzheimer's Disease Center travels round trip 102 miles and spends 2.5 hours of travel time, not including how they get to the clinic, how long it takes them to leave the house, et cetera. And as it closes in on rush hour, I'm sure you're well aware that that can be challenging. That 2.5 hours and 102 miles is equivalent from driving to San Francisco to San Jose at 6 o'clock on a Monday. Twice. Boom, boom. And that's the average travel of a family in a car with a person who has Alzheimer's disease or dementia in order to come get care at our center. So we've developed a few different ways that we can reach out to people without them having to physically come to Palo Alto in order to get care for themselves or care for their families. So currently we have a project that's funded by the Department of Veterans Affairs to do some caregiver support in addition to some caregiver skill building and education through mobile tablet devices that we've customized. And so our goal for that is to improve caregiver quality of life or decrease their burden, but also to decrease their perceived stress and any symptoms of depression they may be experiencing, but also to increase their socialization and engagement in pleasant activities. So we've created a customized Android device that we give to them. As you can see, it's very simplistic, very simplified. We've designed this in conjunction with caregivers who have a lot of experience with technology to those who have never used a smart device in their life. So this is an example of the home screen on that device, so they can easily go to Google, because that's now a verb. They can easily access the internet. At the touch of a button, they can use Google Voice to directly call our staff on the phone. And they also have access to a calendar, which that they can then use for their own purposes, care planning, whatever it is that they'd like to do. They also have access to caregiver resources, which I'll talk a little bit about later. And then they can press the button called Connect to Study, where we do small group interventions with caregivers of persons with dementia. So they press that button, and within 10 seconds, they're delivered directly to our staff, along with other caregivers in a group, so they can receive education and skill building, resource provision, and specifically tailored materials to the types of dementia that they are coping with and the types of stressors that they're experiencing. Each, as you can see on along the bottom of the screen, there are different tabs. There's the caregiver tab, the home tab I already talked about. They click on the caregiver tab. If they tap the caregiver support button, they are connected to the Department of Veterans Affairs 24-hour caregiver support line. If they click on the dementia helpline, that connects them directly to the Alzheimer's Association 24-hour hotline. They can also go to the Alzheimer's Association Caregiver Center, access the Healthy Caregiver Program, or go to the Family Caregiver Alliance website. The Relax button will lead them to various applications focused around breathing exercises, calming, soothing, relaxing sounds, or ways to just generally reduce their arousal level. And then there's the Fun tab, where they can have access to a variety of games that we've put on there for them. They can download any other tools or games or valuable apps that they may be interested in, whether it's Candy Crush or Skype, if they want to connect with family members in another way. We've curated Spotify playlists for them based on a music survey that we give them when they first enter into the program that's matched not just to them, but also to their loved one with dementia, so that that way they have immediate access to songs from genres and eras and types of music that are important to them, but also important to the one that they're caring for. So when they do tap on the caregiver resources button, that then pulls up a curated list of caregiver resources that are all there and available for them. They don't have to go to the internet and search through 20 different websites. They don't have to go to the NIH. They don't have to go to Alzheimer's.org. They don't have to go to Family Caregiver Alliance or Stanford or UCSF or wherever else. They can go directly there. It's organized by category, and they can have access to self-care ideas, support videos, including caregiver skill building, tip sheets, things about exercise, everyday care, and also disease-specific information. So if they're caring for someone who has dementia with Lewy bodies, they can access directly information specifically tailored towards dementia with Lewy bodies, or Alzheimer's disease, or another cause of dementia. We've also noticed that in terms of going towards spending 2.5 hours of time in order to get access to dementia specialty care, and that's regardless of whether they live in San Jose and have to deal with traffic, or if they live far away and don't necessarily have to deal with traffic, but just distance from our center. We've had people travel up to 300 miles to come to our center, one way, 300 miles, because we provide services at no cost. So they can come to us, see a neurologist, see a psychiatrist, get cognitive assessment, get resource provision, diagnosis, treatment recommendations, et cetera, delivered to them at our center, and not have to pay a dime other than whatever the travel costs it takes them to get there. So that can be problematic for traffic, can be also be problematic for people who live in more remote or rural areas. So we've developed a mobile health dementia consultation clinic where they don't actually have to come in at all, and they can sit down with a neurologist in their kitchen. So we UPS them overnight an iPad. And we're piloting that right now. In the future, we're also planning to have, if they have their own iPad, they can come in so they don't have to wait for that process. They can just access directly to the center. Unfortunately, the video for this, I'm gonna talk about technology. Surprisingly, technology didn't work. So I can't demonstrate it. Unfortunately, but that little B button at the bottom, it's all they see when they turn on the iPad. They hit that, and within approximately 10 seconds, they're connected to our center visually and auditorily. So they can hear us, they can see us, we can do cognitive testing with them directly on the device, we can show them stimuli from neuropsychological tests, we can assess their memory in visual ways and in verbal ways, by screen sharing stimuli on the device. And so we send it to them with instructions on how to connect it to the internet. We send it to them with two sets of headphones and a headphone splitter. So that way, if the volume output from the iPad itself isn't enough for them to hear appropriately, the caregiver and the person with dementia can both put headphones on and listen at the same time. So that way, everybody has access to that. After we do the evaluations, we have what we call a family conference, which usually happens about a week later. And family members can call in visually or on the telephone from New York, from Chicago, from Paris, or wherever else that they choose to call in and participate in that and get feedback and ask questions of our staff about their loved ones. So that's how we're helping to bring our center out to other people. We're also trying to help clinicians in clinic with assessments. In a primary care setting, we all know that 12 minutes is probably a luxury. And so there isn't a whole lot of time that can be dedicated to the discussion of dementia warning signs. And so on an annual wellness visit from Medicare, we've developed an app that's in 10 different languages, the 10 most common languages spoken in the state of California. This is a project that's funded by the California Department of Public Health, where they can have an assessment for depression symptoms, as well as warning signs of dementia in 10 different languages. If they don't read a language but speak a language, the app will read them the questions, so that way they can respond yes or no. So it takes literacy out of the equation when it comes to assessment. And that way, if a medical support assistant in a clinic or a physician or a practitioner in the community doesn't speak a language, they can still have an assessment of depression and warning signs for dementia in the native tongue of the person that they're seeing. So if you're interested in helping us to test that application, we just got our very, very first build from the developers earlier this week. So if you're interested in participating in that and helping us hone that and make it better for providers, it will be developed for iOS devices, so Apple devices, Android devices, and Windows 10 devices. So if you go to that link or use that little QR code there, you can sign up to help us beta test that. We're particularly interested in people who speak languages other than English to help us with that, as well as those who are only native English speakers. So thank you very much.